So what is up everyone? I am back and you know why I am here. Because we have got the trailers for the Avengers, officially called the Endgame. Now, we are going to do an official trailer reaction and also analysis. You know, that's what we do. That's what we are here for. I know it's been a long time and this leave of absence is not justified. But still, we have got the trailers. So now, this thing is to be hyped about. And I might have a few things which might lead us into the movie. So hopefully we can pick out a few things, a few little details that might have been missed. And so yeah, let's start with the trailer. You might want to put your headphones in for this one.
Hey, Ms. Potts.
If you find this recording,
don't feel bad about this.
Part of the journey is the end.
Just for the record, being adrift in space with zero promise of rescue is more fun than it sounds. Food and water ran out 4 days ago. Oxygen will run out tomorrow morning. That'll be it. When I drift off, I will dream about you. It's always you.
And the stakes are real for this one. You can feel the tension, you can feel the pressure. I mean, it's really intense. Oh, this is the iconic scene from the comics. But Thanos.
Thanos did exactly what he said he was gonna do. He wiped out 50% of all living creatures.
Yeah.
We lost, all of us. We lost friends. We lost family.
Now Ronin.
We lost a part of
Ronin ourselves. Ronin is the most epic takeaway of this trailer. I might have.
This is the fight of our lives.
This is gonna work, Steve.
I know it is. Because I don't know what I'm going to do if it doesn't.
That's the most scariest thing I've ever heard in all of Marvel movies. I don't know what about this purple
right now. Hi, is anyone home? This is Scott Lang. We met a few years ago at the airport. In Germany, I got really big.
Is this an old message?
Ant-Man, I know you know that.
It's the front door.
That's me. Can you buzz me in?
Wow, that was awesome. That was really awesome. So guys, now, the trailer is 2 minutes long, 2 minutes 25 seconds to be precise, including all the graphics. Now, so guys, from this trailer, the first thing we can pick off is all the Avengers are broken. They are torn apart. Now, as we can see here, Tony and Nebula are drifting off in space. And as he's saying, there are only a day for oxygen and 3 or 4 days without water he has been living. So what I feel is going to happen is the movie will start with Tony and Nebula riding into space. And maybe this will happen after what, a week or 2 weeks, 3 weeks later, because he has a little stubble. Now the beard is not grown very much, so it's not a long time I will predict. So meanwhile on Earth, what will happen is all the Avengers will assemble. As we can see, Thor and Bruce Banner. So when they will come with the terms that what has happened, and they will really know that 50% of everything is wiped out, it will be very difficult for them. Now all I can say is this is the first 30 minutes of the movie, maybe 30 to 40 minutes, all these things will happen, not everything, the Ant-Man part will come later, but I think they will spend a good 30 to 40 minutes explaining all these things and settling down the atmosphere after the snap, because you know, you have to show the consequences, you have to show the stakes that what has happened. So as we can see from the dialogue, Steve told that we lost our family, our friends and part of ourselves, and then we see Hawkeye with this pennant stare in him, and that stare really explains that which state he is in, because I think his family is lost, and we see that other guy, that Japanese or the Japanese guy, was cast in the role, and that casting came a few days before. So I don't know what he's playing, but he might not be an important character, but still he will play an integral part in Hawkeye story, I think, maybe. But that is really intense seeing Hawkeye in that view, because he looks a badass, but he looks like a villain. When you see a villain's eye, you know it's villain. So the real concern for me is Steve and Tony reuniting. We do not see them together in this trailer, and Tony is drifting off somewhere in space. I don't know if he'll come in the movie or not, at which part he'll come into the movie. I think for 30 minutes he'll be out in space just riding about. And I also know, I have no clue how he'll come to Earth, and because at this time it seems like he has nothing. If somebody gets this message, then maybe they have a chance of bringing him back in. But other than that, the Milano is riding into space. Now when we see Bruce Banner looking at all those pictures from the people who are not there or who have been missing or who have been taken away by the snap, we see Shuri, we see Peter Parker, and we also see Scott Lang. Now we know Scott Lang was struck in the time vortex or quantum realm as we know it, but he is also missing, so he will also not come back into the movie. But the main takeaway is Shuri is missing. Now this puts a big question mark on the Wakandan throne. Who will handle Wakanda, and what will happen after the Avengers get out of Wakanda? Now what I think will happen is M'Baku will take the throne, and maybe he will salvage everything that Wakanda has right now. Now you might be thinking, what will happen next? So I have a really cool theory, not cool, but I think what they are trying to tell us from this trailer is time travel. Now we know that is going to happen, and they have to bring all those people back, because time travel is the thing. But when the Avengers logo pops up, we see broken pieces of the Avengers title. But that title is being resurrected, and the title is being brought back together by the circular thing rotating. And that, I think, signifies the entire story of this Avengers movie. That they will have to redo everything that has happened, and for that they will have to merge together. So it's the end game. In the end game, I think they will have to come back together. Because there is only one way of redoing all this, and that is to bring back all the people, to bring back all the original 6 Avengers that were in the first movie, and to reunite them and to make a plan that can work, definitely. So for the plan, I think that Quantum Realm is a key thing, because Scott Lang comes with a truck that Hank Pym was working in, and that truck has a lot of quantum stuff, that is the quantum tunnel, which put Ant-Man back into the quantum realm. So Ant-Man is definitely getting out of the quantum realm, that is the thing. Now how he's getting out, they will explain that in the movie, and they will have to explain it very, very properly, because it's a big question mark how the quantum realm works. And as we saw from the Ant-Man and the Wasp deleted scene, that the quantum realm has its own civilizations, its own people also, and its own territories. So it's very confusing. They will have to explain this whole Scott Lang thing first, in the first 30 to 40 minutes probably, because this movie is 3 hours long, that we should not forget. But this is the main thing that we have to take away, that the quantum realm will be playing a big part, and Ant-Man is definitely getting out. So the people who are worried about Ant-Man being stuck in the quantum realm, don't worry, he will get out some way. And when he will get out, he will be the key to all things. That also we should remember, because mark my words, when he comes back to the Avengers base, that is when the things will start coming into the avalanche. And that scene where Steve speaks that I don't know what will I do if it doesn't, that is, I think, in later in the movie, where they are trying to get into the quantum realm or go into the zone, or I don't know, maybe do any time travel stuff. But I think that is later in the movie, because that is not starting. You can see they are serious about what they are doing, and they are not sure what is happening. I thought that we will see more of what the plot has to offer, but the Russos are very smart, and they know how to make their stories and make their trailers. They gave us something, but they still did not give us anything. And for the title, I think that is a good title. Avengers Endgame really looks a nice title. So we'll see how this ends. Now I am very worried, because I think that they will have to do something that has not been done before. Maybe even sacrifice some of the original Avengers. But it'll be very nice to see what happens next. And let us wait for the next trailer. And tomorrow maybe Spider-Man Homecoming trailer is coming. So maybe I'll react to that too. And we know Spider-Man is coming after Avengers. So he's getting resurrected, and how he's getting resurrected is another thing, but we'll have to see for the trailer what happens. So guys, now I'm signing off. If you feel that you got a little more light onto the Avengers trailer after watching this breakdown, and if you knew a little more about the movie than before, then please feel free to like, share and subscribe. And also don't forget to stay tuned for the next videos, because you know we'll be doing a lot of this Avengers stuff from now on. So if there is any information that I get, I'll be happy to pass it on through videos. And until then, this is signing off from TikTok.